Alright guys, a little bit of shop time today. If you've seen the shorts that I put on the channel, you would know that I poured some liquid resin, hardened it up, put some color on it. Now, we're going to try and see if we can shape it without it shattering into a couple million pieces. Stay with us. Alright, here we go. We're just going to chew it up a little bit more. The ends. This end. And now we got a true piece to work with. We're gonna cut the lanyard groove in it. At this point, the overall length is not done yet. Add a little bit of shape. You gotta make sure you're wearing safety glasses when you're doing this, because this stuff will chip. It will get in your eye. We're gonna have to tighten things up a little bit here. Thank you. You have to take your time with this. You cannot go fast. It will just chip and shatter. Starting to get close to where we want to be. I don't know if the camera's picking it up or not, but if you don't run the tool smooth across all the way here, it will just dig and leave grooves in there all the way along, which will just make it a lot harder on the sanding process. So the shape's coming along a little bit here. The shape's coming along pretty good. Okay, so this end down here, this seems to be a little too wide for me, so I'm going to shorten it up a little bit. Hear the difference there. Look at the coloration. Hopefully you can see that on the camera, the coloration. The tool dug too deep. So now I've got a groove there and a groove there. You'd be sanding for hours trying to get that out. So we're gonna try and get it out without making any more damage. See a little bit left right there, but that's less sanding I gotta do. I'm gonna open up the mouth piece a little bit. In order to do that, I'm using this, this is actually just a drill bit. It's got a nice sharp edge on it, and it's small. Which means I can get it in alongside the spindle. Just like that, the mouthpiece is open. Thank you. It's not too bad. It's coming along. I've got to straighten out this edge here a little bit because it kind of got rounded over. As this thing turns, it gets hot on the inside. So it'll move around on the mandrel a little bit, which is not ideal. But you got to work with it. See what we got. I'm not sure you can see this, but you can see a bit of a shiny piece here, and it's not shiny here, which means the groove didn't go all the way around. So see, the groove is pretty scarce there. I want it to go all the way around the call. If you take it off, you can't put it back on. Okay, now we got the groove going all the way around. We got the lanyard groove. Bottom piece that needs to be cleaned up a little bit. And smooth around the mouthpiece. Now I can feel grooves in here. You probably can't see it, but I can feel the grooves in there, which means the tool was moving a little too quick. couple causes of that. My tool rest is getting beat up and I may not be that steady, so. And you can do all kinds of things. You can put another groove on this portion here. You can put another groove underneath the lip here, or you can just sand it down, leave it matte black, which is what this one's gonna be, is matte black. Just clean up this end a little bit. All right, now to my least favorite part, the sanding. All the little grooves that were left by the tool, you can get them out with the sandpaper. This takes a little longer. Alright guys, I'm not going to bore you with the rest of the sanding, but here it is here. You can make whatever shape you want to make, and you can make mistakes and then find something else that you like. There's the mouthpiece that's got to be opened up just a little bit more. The sanding, I got to take this right up to 1500 grit so I can get it smooth right out, and then it'll be where I want it to be. Then we just add an insert. At the end of the day, I still like working with wood better. This one here, a lot harder to work with because it'll chip, it'll crack, it'll do whatever. The wood, look at the character in that. You tell me, leave me a comment down below. You prefer a wood call or an acrylic call? Now you can buy acrylic blanks done from a factory, come in and work with them the same way. Nevertheless, I still like the wood better. You tell me what you like. Anyway, that's all I got for today's video. Hope you got something out of that. A little bit of shop time because it's raining outside. Hoping to get duck hunting tonight. If I get there, you'll know because you're coming along with me. Other than that, I'll see you all in the next one. I'm going with the wood.